it's Sarah with registerednursern.com, and in this video, I'm going to talk about the different types of cardiac stress tests. Now, I've spent most of my career as a cardiac nurse, and I've actually worked in a stress lab. So in this video, I want to talk to you about why a stress test is ordered, the equipment used, the different types of stress tests out there that a doctor may order, and the common side effects that a patient could expect to have whenever they receive any type of chemical stress test. So hopefully this will just help you, give you a good idea about what to expect. So why do doctors order cardiac stress tests? Many times a physician, either your primary care doctor or a doctor in a hospital, will order a cardiac stress test to evaluate the blood flow to your heart. Many times a patient may be having chest pain, or they've came in for a checkup and the doctor did an EKG and they noticed just some little subtle changes, and they want to make sure that you don't have any cardiac disease. And a cardiac stress test is one of the most non-invasive ways to look at that. And if your stress test comes back abnormal, normally you'll be referred to a cardiologist, and maybe the cardiologist will recommend a heart catheterization. So with a stress test, you can be ordered a variety. Some have the nuclear imaging, where you'll take pictures, do a stress test, take pictures again, and the cardiologist will look at the pictures. Some physicians will order just a cardiac stress test, where you just exercise on a treadmill and there's no imaging involved. And then another type is you'll exercise and get an echocardiogram in between exercising, which I'll go over here in a second. So what type of equipment is used whenever you're doing a stress test? Now, this depends on what type of stress test you are doing, because there's four different types. But generally, you'll have to have an IV inserted. You'll be hooked up to an EKG machine, where you'll get continuous EKG, 12-lead EKGs. You'll have a blood pressure cuff on, an SpO2 monitor, which will monitor your oxygen saturation. If you do the nuclear imaging, you'll have to lay under a heart scanning machine 2 times. And if you do the exercise stress test without the chemical, you will be on a treadmill. Okay, let's talk about the different types of stress tests. First, I'm going to go over the nuclear stress test. This is where a nuclear radioactive agent is used. Generally, most facilities use the agent called cardiolite. Some may use different ones, but the ones I have worked at use cardiolite. And if you are getting a stress test with nuclear imaging, expect the test to take anywhere from 2 to 4 hours. Because what happens is that you arrive, you get your IV, you get injected with this cardiolite, and it takes an hour to circulate through your system and to collect in your heart. Then after that, you will set and you will take images. Take about 15 minutes for imaging. Then you'll go to the stress lab and you will do the stress part of the test, where you'll get stress on your heart either through a chemical, which I'll go over here in a second, Lexiscan or dobutamine, or through physical exercise through a treadmill. Then you'll get injected again with the cardiolite isotope, and you have to wait another hour and then get another set of imaging. So everything from start to finish takes about 4 hours. And like I said, you have, if you do the chemical route, which is the nuclear with chemical, either they'll use what's called Lexiscan. Back in the day, they used adenosine. So if you've heard of adenosine, they've now switched to Lexiscan. Patients report less side effects, less discomfort, although some patients will have the side effects with it, which I'll go over here in a second, or dobutamine. Typically, if a patient has any type of asthma, active wheezing, anything like that, or they had a really bad adverse reaction to Lexiscan, the doctor will order dobutamine. Now, Lexiscan, how it works, it dilates the coronary arteries on your heart. So whenever the nurse or whoever's injecting this Lexiscan into you, it takes about 5 to 10 seconds, you'll all of a sudden feel this warm sensation in your face. You could feel, you may not feel, some patients I've had, they don't even feel anything, but you could feel a little shortness of breath, tingling in your arms and legs, nausea, abdominal cramps. You may have to go use the bathroom afterwards because you have all this increased blood flow going to the stomach, and a headache. Now the dobutamine, if you get dobutamine, what it is it's an IV drip. So whoever's hooking you up to the medication, you'll have a drip, and it'll drip into your IV, and they'll increase it over time. And what they're waiting for is for your heart to increase to a certain target. And this target is usually based on your age. And once you hit that target heart rate, they'll inject you with the radioactive isotope. And typically what a patient experiences with the dobutamine is that they just feel their chest, their heart pounding, and their face feels warm because it's like they're exercising and running. Because these are chemically induced to simulate like if you were actually really doing exercise yourself. The next type is a regular exercise stress test with the nuclear imaging, and generally this is performed on a treadmill. So what will happen is that the patient will get up on a treadmill, and most facilities use Bruce protocol, meaning that the treadmill will start out really slow, and then every 3 minutes the treadmill will get steeper and faster and will incline and speed up, like I said, and we'll be monitoring your heart rate, looking for any EKG changes. And once you hit a target heart rate, they will inject you with the radioactive isotope. And then you'll get off the treadmill, recover, just like with the chemical, you would just recover and you'd be sitting in bed, you wouldn't be exercising. And then after an hour from where you had either the chemical or exercise, you would weigh and take another set of pictures. Okay, now the next kind that you can have is called the routine exercise stress test with no nuclear. And this is where you just get up on the treadmill, you'll be connected to all this equipment, the EKG machine, blood pressure cuff, all that, and you will just exercise until you hit a target heart rate using the Bruce protocol. And what the person who's watching your EKG, some facilities require a doctor or nurse practitioner to do it, or some facilities will let the registered nurse do it. But what they're doing is they're waiting for your heart rate to hit that target and looking for any changes or any symptoms that you may be having. It's not as in-depth as the nuclear imaging because you won't have that with it. So say that something showed up, like you had some EKG changes or you had excruciating chest pain with that, they may have you come back and do a nuclear one to further evaluate it. And then last but not least is the stress echocardiogram. This can be a chemical or it can be a treadmill. You can set in bed where they will induce the physical exercise, or you can exercise yourself. And how this works is you do not get any nuclear imaging at all. You will get a resting echocardiogram. This is an ultrasound of the heart, and it's looking at the pumping function of your heart. And then they'll do the physical exercise on your heart. Either you'll get up on a treadmill and exercise, or they'll do dobutamine. Lexiscan is not used with the stress echocardiogram because the big deal with this is that you have to get your heart rate up. Lexiscan does not increase the heart rate. It just dilates the coronary arteries like a nitrate. It's part of the nitrate family. So once you hit your target heart rate, either on the treadmill yourself or the dobutamine, they will hurry up and get an echocardiogram on your heart while it's really beating really fast, and see how well the perfusion's going to the heart. Now, let's real fast talk about some prep that you would have to do if you're having any of these tests. For your chemical stress test and the exercise stress test with nuclear, you'll have to usually this, every hospital, every facility has different protocols, so you always want to check with them, but this is generally how it is. You'll want to be nothing by mouth for at least 4 to 6 hours. For the chemical, if you're getting Lexiscan, you'll want to make sure that you're not taking any Agrinox or Presantine for at least 72 hours. These interact with Lexiscan. Or you haven't had anything called theophylline or aminophylline in 24 hours. This is actually the antidote for Lexiscan, so it wouldn't work. And make sure you haven't consumed any caffeine products. This includes coffee, tea, anything with caffeine, even medications for at least 24 hours. And sometimes some cardiologists don't even want you to have decaf, because when you have caffeine, what it does is it constricts everything. And what we're trying to do with Lexiscan is dilate everything. And if you have caffeine in your system, nothing will dilate. Okay, for the exercise nuclear stress test, or if you were doing dobutamine, remember with this, we're trying to increase your heart rate. So you would want to ask your physician if you should take your beta blockers. Normally, they want you to hold any beta blockers because our goal is to get your heart rate up. And if you're taking beta blockers, that's going to block your heart rate from getting up. And if you have a patient who's inpatient, who's getting any of these tests, you probably want to report to the stress lab or the cardiologist if they've had any positive troponins. Usually most facilities want a patient to have 2 or 3 troponin levels before they have this test. Any abnormal labs like hemoglobins, hematocrits, potassiums, anything abnormal, magnesium, calcium, phosphorus, and any positive D-dimers, because that could signify that they may have some blood clots in their lungs or something like that. And usually a CT with PE protocol is ordered before they have the stress test, just to rule that out. And then as a side note, if this patient is going for a nuclear imaging stress test, make sure that they haven't had a VQ scan. Usually that's used to look to see if there's any blood clots in the lungs for at least 48 hours prior to the test, because the nuclear agent they use with that, we don't want to give them so much of radioactive material. We like to space it out. Okay, next, let's talk about some prep for the routine exercise stress test. With that, remember, you're just exercising on the treadmill. So you'll have to get an IV, and you'll have to make sure that you're not taking any of your beta blockers, because they want to get your heart rate up. And you usually have to be nothing by mouth for at least 4 hours prior to that as well. And the stress echocardiogram, the prep for that is similar to these up here. Again, you'll have to be nothing by mouth for about 4 hours. You'll have to have an IV, and the beta blockers may be an issue as well, because the key with that is getting your heart rate up. So that is a little bit about the different types of stress tests. Please check out our other videos on cardiac stress tests for a more in-depth description about each drug. And thank you so much for watching, and please consider subscribing to this YouTube channel.